hope you guys are having as much fun as I am with this, and we are just getting started. Please, if what I say does not make sense to you, if I forget something or I leave something out, please ask. There's a lot of other people in there that have questions, and it might be the same question that you are you're thinking of. So please, let me know. We're gonna get started with this form right here. These are the three different static phases where it's like we take a snapshot while you're running, and there's a certain point in that, and we break that down into these three phases. These are gonna help us to determine and diagnose each form fault. The one that we're gonna go over today is initial foot flat, where IFF, where your foot is flat, where we're seeing where that weight acceptance is. And this is how we're gonna diagnose if you're overstriding. What I've learned is the more simple that we keep this, the more just pass-fail criteria, it helps improve the validity of it, how accurate we are at measuring what we're trying to measure, overstriding, and what's the reliability. If I look at the same video 2 days apart, am I gonna have the same results, pass, fail? And then if I look and you look, what's the reliability of that? Do we both have similar answers? So in order to do that, we have to make this standardized as possible. And I'm gonna share with you how we used to look at it and how I'm gonna propose that we do this now. So that way you know, pass, fail, overstride, work on it. If not, move on with your life. Okay, so if you'll recall from the L2R SOP, we had two different views, two different distances that we did. The first one was that 12 steps away. That gives us our runway. It gives us 10 strides in the frame. We're only gonna be using that week two with the bounding, the excessive vertical, to diagnose that. Weeks one, overstriding, and weeks three, posture, we're gonna use this view, this closer view, the slow motion, 120 frames per second, to give us our answers and our diagnosis and define that frozen, that frame rate, that different phase of running. So this is gonna show you guys how we find IFF, initial foot flat. You don't have to have fancy software. You can just use your phone to find this position and how we're gonna diagnose it. All right, let's take it step by step. So right here, we have this flight phase. The way that we used to try to diagnose overstriding was we would look to see where is that foot initially making contact with the ground. We call this initial contact. Then we decided, okay, what about the knee flexion angle? We had to measure that. That muddied the water as far as reliability. I might find something different than you. You need fancy software or programs. Then we were trying to say, well, let's just kind of guesstimate where the center of mass is. And then there's no normative values or data of how close to that line do we land. So it's very arbitrary. It wasn't cut and dry. And the other problem with this is my shoe has built-in cushion and a heel height, a stack height. If I've got 12 millimeters of a heel height and then a bunch of cushion, my foot, my weight might not really even be on the ground yet. I'm not actually transferring it. So yes, if this was the old criteria of overstriding or not, you can see why that might be passes, yes, overstriding. I'm gonna show you why though, that this is not. Because we talk about the definition of what overstriding does is it slows us down. We're trying to have our momentum go forward and keep it moving forward. Instead of stopping here, what you're gonna do is you're gonna find that exact moment where the foot is completely flat. This is where we're starting to have that weight being transferred back up to the chain. Again, remembering every action equal and opposite. So here now I know my weight is in my foot, my weight's coming back up at me, and this right here is our starting point. This is where we're gonna help to determine, are we overstriding or not? So how are we gonna do that? So how can I determine? How can I determine from a static picture if my momentum is going forward and where my weight is where it needs to be? How can I connect my lower body and my upper body to give me a better picture? What we're gonna do is this bottom bone is called the tibia. This, your thorax, your torso, we're gonna call it a torso, TT. If this is parallel with this, that's gonna match our first criteria. That's gonna satisfy criteria one. Criteria two is, are both of these lines starting to go forward? Are they falling forward? Are they in line with my momentum? And we'll see why that is. How we find these is we've got a couple landmarks. So this is how you're gonna frame out the tibia and the torso. All you need is a credit card, a driver's license, two cards. What you're gonna do is you're gonna identify the lateral malleolus. That's fancy talk for just that center little bone, that circle on the outside of your ankle, and then the outside of your knee, right in the middle. So you connect those. So that's number one. Number two, I'm gonna just what we call split or bifurcate my torso in half. I'm gonna cut myself in half from the side. I know, it sounds crazy. That's my second spot. So here it is, and I'll break this down more in a second. If these two are both parallel, which they are, and they're both falling forward, then I pass. Failing and overstriding is either gonna be not parallel or the lines are not going forward. So this is it. This is the form that I posted this morning that you can screenshot. This is your guide. After you get the hang of this, you're not gonna need this every time. To diagnose you as overstriding, to be guilty of overstriding, cards are not parallel. We talked about that. And the cards are not forward. Let's go over the three most common examples of that. This is the one we did where I'm good, I'm parallel. These are the two most common ways that we'll fail or we're overstriding. Here, notice how this first line, as I go through that bone, and then my body, I'm too hinged. I'm hinged at the hip, not good. See how those are not parallel? So that fails. That shows that my weight, my lower bone, my tibia is still out in front of me, over striding. The other one is they're still parallel. You can all agree, but look what I'm doing. I'm leaning back, and we see this all the time. If you don't believe me, go just watch people run. This is so common. People are leaning back. Just how we talked about the other day, things coming full circle. This is how I should be running downhill. Leaning back, landing out in front of me to slow me down so I don't fall flat on my face. If I'm running on a flat surface, that's slowing me down. So here, we can all agree that these are parallel, but they're not moving forward. So I fail that criteria. This is what I'll be using on Thursday when I go through, and everybody that posts to your page, you running, especially just the slow motion position for week one, hashtag L2RSOP, Thursday live, I'm just gonna go up here and everyone that does it, I'm gonna press play, I'm gonna take you through it. And I'm gonna go through, show you my reasoning, explain why not. And there's other cues that I'll talk about, like other pearls on when we're live, about the hand position, about arms. There's other things that are typically associated with this that aren't as cut and dry, but you can kind of get into my head and just start to know overstriding. If you don't know what overstriding is, you can't correct it. So hope that made sense. Let me know.